What's up, everybody? Cloud Chord here. I want to remind you, I'm dropping a new album May 15th, and you can click the link below in the description to enter to win a free lesson with me if you pre-save the album. So today we're going to be talking about sampling Miles Davis. The other night I woke up in the middle of the night and I just had this realization of I want to show people about sampling Miles Davis. So I'm taking his most iconic song, So What, and chopping it up, and here's the end result. Second part. All right. So let's check out how I made it. So I'm going to kind of wing it for you, and we're going to be able to cover a bunch of different stuff here. First of all, I'm going to drag in an MP3 of Miles. So if I go over to my places here into my downloads, I'm going to look up So What, and there it is. So I got an MP3. Now I want to use Simpler, which is our simple sampler. And there's a bunch of ways I could get it into Simpler, but I think one of the most easy ways is to double click on this MIDI and then see if down the bottom it says drop an instrument or sample here so you can audition it. I'm going to pull it into here. Cool. So now we have Miles Davis's So What inside an instance of Simpler, which is the simple sampler, which you can find inside instruments as well. So there's three modes. There's classic mode, which is treats it kind of like sampling a piano, where it always starts from the same place. So it's pitch based. You can play it like a piano. I could do chords and it would always start from the same place. Let me find somewhere even more obvious. Cool, so that's classic mode. One-shot mode, think of it like drums. It starts from the same place. But you can't do polyphony. So it'll only play the latest note, the most recent note. So today I'm going to use what's called slice mode. And if I open up the toggle expand view, we can see a larger version of it. So I don't even really know what I want to sample, but I thought this would just be a cool way to look at a bunch of different ways you can use Simpler to sample an icon in jazz. First of all, let's look at in slice mode. We go over here, slice by, and we can slice by transient. So if I slice by transient, which is the default right now, so it's slicing by the onset of each new wave. Now we could also do beat. So this is like a 9 minute tune. So we obviously can't at a quarter note division slice the whole sample, right? And this all starts from where my initial marker is right here. So it'll slice by beat from wherever I go. I think I wanna mainly do the beginning though. And so we could do that. And then we could also slice by region so it can break it up into bigger chunks. That's cool for maybe like a 16 bar phrase or something like that. And then last but not least, one more thing about by region, you can determine your number of regions here. So that's pretty cool. Playback mono versus poly. Are you going to do one slice at a time in mono? You're going to do multiple slices, and then through would allow it to play through different slices. So you can hit one slice, and if the MIDI note continues, it'll go to the next slice. Anyways, we're going to do mono. We're going to do slice manually. We're going to start over here. And let me find, how about like four slices? Okay. So that's a pretty cool one. So a lot of times, let me throw this into gate. So what that does, trigger, it just goes on and on and on. When I move it to gate, It's actually real time, like an instrument, to where I let up on the note on my push and the note stops. Cool. So I think I created a second slice there by mistake. So what you can do is go and double click that. What I'm going to do on my push is create some new slices real time. Here's the first one. Let me just throw it into trigger so we can kind of cruise through it all. Like that horn one there. A lot of times you can do this visually by seeing things that seem new. I like that because that's the hit with just the piano. Now here's the modulation. So look, see, so far I have four slices. And then. They're all kind of the same thing. So maybe I want something else. So how about like over here? What's that sound like? And here's a neat thing. I can zoom in. You can actually take these slices and move them around. Cool. So I think I'll try to do a couple more slices when Miles actually comes in with the initial famous solo of his. Is it right here? Yeah, so let me put it back in trigger. All right, so here's my slices so far. Let me zoom back out. So I'm gonna do a little bit of maintenance here, get them all a little bit cleaner on the downbeats. Better. Let's see that one. Next one. Not bad. Last one. That's going to be cool. We're going to have to do some volume automation for that though later on. Cool. So now what I do is let me go into my user library and I'm going to grab a drum clip. So got these ALC files. I'll do an ALC file tutorial some other time, but basically they're pre-warped clips in this folder. So I grab this. All right, so that makes me realize our sample is a little bit low. So, and I'm also going to turn down my velocity here. So now we can pull this back a little bit. Now, here's where the fun starts. I can just start chopping away. And for those of you that don't have a push or any kind of MIDI instrument device, you can go over here to your computer MIDI keyboard and you could try to use your keyboard. So right now I'm touching it and it's not working, which means I'm in the wrong octave. So I'm probably too high, so I can hit the Z key down several and there I am. Cool. So right now I'm using the A, S, D, and F keys. So let's try it. I'm just going to audition a little bit with this beat. cool. Let's try it out. So I'm going to record it. Now we got a MIDI clip. Looks like this. Let me hit the fold button so now you can see what we got. It is only 5 discrete notes or slices. Each one of these notes is a slice here or here if you want to zoom in a little bit. All right, so let's go back to this MIDI clip. Shift tab is a nice hot key to change your view from the MIDI clip to the device view, which is here to here. So cool. So I might tweak that last one a little bit, change it up. So this kind of gets into philosophy of like, how close are we to the end? Are we thinking 3-minute tune or are we thinking 8-measure beat? I think for the purpose of today, just to show how you can use simpler, let's just say a simple 8-measure beat. So right now we've got 4 measures. So what we could do is just hit duplicate loop over here. Now we got 8 and I can just do some simple changes to the second half. Cool. Nothing mind-blowing, but think about maybe the purpose of this is having a vocalist or an MC or just kind of maybe a jam track for Instagram or something like that. So if it were up to me, and it is right now at this point, I think the next thing I would do is here's a cool trick. So this is a cool little Freddie Joachim drum break. Go down here into the sample editor and I'm going to right click and I'm going to convert drums to new MIDI track. And then let's see how it sounds. Solo it up. It's the rhythmic essence of the drum break with way less cool sounds. So I'm going to hit my hot swap button over here. I'm going to go into my user library. I'm going to grab my Cloud Trap Kit. All right, now let's see how it sounds. So really what I'm looking for is the essence of a fatter kick and snare. So mute up my hats. Let's see how that sounds together without Miles. Not bad. And what I might even do is actually simplify this snare so that it can just be on the 2 and 4 mainly. And we can let that break have all of that syncopated flavor. Let's just make it like a 2-measure drum loop. So it's got the kick pattern, but now it's got a simpler snare pattern. And what I'll do here is I'm going to add a high pass, low cut kind of thing. So I use low cut, high pass so much that I just have a preset on FabFilter. So together, they sound like this. So it's cool. And what I might even do, let me do one more thing. Going to sidechain my break to my drums. Kind of getting away from Miles right now, but this is realistically what I would do. So there's my kick. Now let's put that same sidechain. I just literally copied it. Now I'm going to paste it on Miles. and then put Miles back in. Cool. So let's do one more thing. Let's do a second chop and see if I do any better. So we got over here. Remind myself of my slices. All right, so. Something simple like that. Three slices. Check it out. I messed it up. Let's try it again. So it's letters W, E, and F on my keyboard. Whoa, look at that. Cool. So let's do one more thing. I have a degree in jazz guitar, and I know that this song is in D minor Dorian, blah, blah, blah. But let's say you don't know much about music theory, and you want a little more low end in this tune. This is a trick that I do in sampling a lot, to where you want kind of a bass line, but you don't have the skills to decode, in theory, what's going on and what the right notes are. So what I'd do is I would duplicate this So What track, and then let's go over, let's get an EQ8. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a low pass at 120. Let's put that before the sidechain, and I'm gonna call this our sub, and it's gonna sound like this. So now we can really hear the bass there. And I might even, I'm gonna throw a glue compressor on there. And the glue has a really cool, I like the low end extender. Punches a little more. Might have a little bit too much sustain and ringing out, so we might have to really sidechain it like crazy. And then what I'll do is I'm going to copy this and I'm going to throw this same EQ on my simpler track. And then I'm just going to simply make it the opposite. There's a lot of ways I could have done that, but I like to put them in two different tracks. I could have made a rack and done it as well. Okay, so no sub in this one, and then only sub. And so we got a little bit more control. And so you know that the bass information is gonna work. Cool, so here is our two scenes. Second one. Cool. Thanks for watching Sampling Miles Davis. Free download for this in the description. See you next time.
Thanks for watching my dad's videos. His name is Derek and he makes music as Cloud Chord, like his hat.
I'm also a guitarist and Ableton certified trainer. Every Tuesday I upload new videos. So if you learned something, be sure to
like and subscribe. And his hat is really cool.